This video will explain how to export DICOM from the Sodexis 4 software. The first thing to do is find your patient, double click on the right corner to pull up the 3D view, and then you click Tools, and you click this little button right here. You hover over it. It's called Send Image to Communication Partner. It's sending it to my desktop to a folder that I pre-made. It'll be about 500 slices. It's a very large folder. It's important that when you scan for cone beam for CT planning, that you scan the patient with the high resolution off. You want to scan it in low res. The only time you need high res is when you're performing an endo scan. For cone beam, leave it off, and then your file size won't be too large. So go to the desktop. Here's a folder I've already made, and I'll give you some more details of how I did that in a minute. And then here's the patient, and this is what your folder will look like, full of DICOM files. You go back, you right click, send to compressed zipped folder. It'll make another folder right next to it that has a little zipper on it, and that is what you'll upload from our website. We'll watch the video all the way through. And there's your zipped folder, and that's what you'll grab when you upload. To set up the communication partner, this is what you'll need to do the first time that you export to our laboratory. You go to Settings, up here in the top right corner, Settings. You'll go to Communication Partner here, highlighted in blue, click it. And what you'll do is you'll name it. I named it Desktop. But you can name whatever you'd like. And then where are you going to save it? You click the little box here, you browse for the desktop, you make a new folder. Call it Row DICOM Exports. Okay. And then, it already exists. Okay. Row DICOM Exports 2. Fine. You click okay. Now there's a folder on the desktop. You click Patient Database. You click Image Exchange, which turns on this part down here. Then you click on Integrate Patient Name and Image Name. And then you click in the bottom right corner, Save. Now what I didn't tell you was the first thing you'll do is you'll click Add down here. And that will open up all the windows and you'll add a new communication partner. Click Save. And there you go. And then when you pull up your 3D, you go to Tools, you click the button here for export, and voila, it starts exporting. I'm going to hit cancel. If you need help with this, our laboratory is here to help you. Give us a call.